स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम बैक टू बायोलॉजी क्लासेस वी आर डिस्कसिंग एंड्रियन एवोल्यूशन अंडर दैट इन दिस पार्ट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस न्यू कांसेप्ट इज सेक्स डिटरमिनेशन सो व्हाट इज सेक्स डिटरमिनेशन हाउ द सेक्स ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनिज्म कैन बी डिटरमाइंड दैट इज वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस नाउ So what is sex determination? Sex determination. So what is sex determination means? Knowing the sex of baby. So before going to be delivered. Understand? So what it is called as sex determination? That is scientific estimation of sex of an offspring during fertilization. So what is fertilization we have studied is fusion of male and female gamete. During fusion of male and female gamete, what type of chromosome is going to fuse with the chromosomes of egg cell? Understand? So during this stage, at fertilization stage, we can estimate what gender is going to be developed in the mother's womb. That is what we call as sex determination or estimation of the gender of an offspring. That what we call sex determination. So estimation, sex of an organism or offspring. This is the male gamete, this is the female gamete. It consisting of nucleus in that we have seen the presence of chromosome. The same condition here also. So, this chromosome, what type of chromosome is going to fuse with the chromosome of egg cell? So, that earlier stage of embryonic development, we can estimate the gender of an organism. That is a newborn baby, whether it is a boy or a girl child, will be going to delivered by a mother. That we can estimate earlier embryonic development stage. And then what do we call as a sex determination. So this sex determination can be carried out by genetically. So sex can be estimated by genetically as well as and also by using environmental factors. So the environment also used in estimation or discovery of gender of an offspring. So environmental factor, the main thing is the temperature. The temperature of the environment that plays a key role in the estimation or knowing the gender of an organism. So, if you observe in case of snail, the environment is used in estimation of the gender of offspring. So, in general, the snail which were produced all are male in nature. Understand? So all the snail are produced as a male in nature. Understand? When these male snail all are grouped together, when a group of snail is close to each other, they start developing into female. Understand? So when they were close to each other, they start converting into female. When they detach or when they are moving away from each other, they again come back to the male organism. When they are converting into female, that time they are allowed to mate and the carrier reproduce. When they are moving away, again they becomes to normally male organism. In this way, the environment also one of the factor that helps in estimation of a gender of an organism, whether it is male, baby, or
or female baby. That is what we can estimate earlier embryonic development. So, in case of snail, all are male. So, when all male is grouped, when all snails are grouped, they cannot switch to female. When they are again moving back, the backs to the male. That is the one example. And next, the incubation temperature of the eggs that hatch into the young one. So, the incubation temperature, how much is present, whether it is more than 20 plus or less than 20, that temperature also one of the factor that helps in formation of a new organism, either male or female. For example, if you take in case of tortoise, if the temperature is more than 20 plus, the egg hatch into female. If the temperature is less than 20, the egg hatch into male. So what is the factor here? In estimation of the sex is temperature. Temperature is the environmental factor. That is the way in which we can see that the temperature also one of the factor that helps in estimation of or determination of sex of an newborn baby. Understand? So, the temperature is of 30. The incubation temperature increases. The egg hatch into female. In case if temperature is decreases, the hatch into male organism. In this way, here in some cases the temperature, or not only genes, in some cases the environmental factor also play a key role in the estimation or determination of sex of an individual. Understand? This is what a sex determination by the environmental factor in snail. The environment plays a key role in development of a genders. If all the male snail close together, they convert into female. Again, they move away, they convert into male. In case of the turtle or tortoise, they lay eggs. After laying the eggs, if during incubation, if the temperature is increases, the egg hatch and produces a female turtle. Whereas if the temperature is less, egg hatch into male. That is what we can see. Environment is one of the factor that helps in development of sex of an individual. That is what we can see. Now, the sex determination by using genetically, this can be studied in human beings now. So, as we have seen, the human being consisting of totally 46 chromosomes or 23 pairs chromosomes. Remember, the human being consisting of 46 chromosomes or they consisting of 23 pairs. 23 pairs means 46. So here asked as 46 chromosomes. Here is asked 23 pairs of chromosomes. So the human being consisting of the number of chromosomes is 46. Number of chromosomes is 46. Number of pair is 23. Remember. Now, out of 46 chromosomes or 23 pairs, the chromosomes are divided into two types. Autosomes and allosomes. Understand? These 46 chromosomes are divided into two types of chromosomes. What are that? Autosomes and allosomes. The autosomes are 22 pairs. 22 pairs means 44 chromosomes. That is autosomes. Whereas allosomes are one pair. two chromosomes. Understand? The human being consisting of totally 46 chromosomes. Out of 46 chromosomes, they were divided into autosomes and allosomes. So, autosomes are the chromosomes which are found on non-reproductive cells, means other than the gametes. Understand? These autosomes are found in non-reproductive cells other than gametes, means they are found in different parts of our body, in tissues and muscles and other internal organs. That is what you can see, the autosomes are found in non-reproductive cells, whereas the allosomes are found in reproductive organs, like it is produced in gametes. Understand? This is what the chromosomes which are found. So, if you observe, the allosomes are the chromosomes that helps in determination of sex. Understand? So, these, why? Because the autosomes, chromosomes, they do not inherit or they do not transfer the characters. Whereas allosomes, they can transfer the characters from one generation to the next generation. So, this chromosome is used in estimation of sex of an individual. So, allosomes are used to estimate sex of an individual. Why? Because these were transfers the characters. Understand? Now, how these chromosomes and what are the chromosome allosome types are present? If you observe the allosomes here, the male consisting of XY type of a chromosome, one pair in male. Understand? And the female consisting of XX chromosomes are present. Understand? So, XY is found in male and XX pair of chromosome is present in female. Now, if you observe, here both chromosome present in female is homologous, and here you can see it is heterologous. Due to this heterologous condition, the male organism plays an important role in the estimation of sex of human beings. So, father is playing a key role in the estimation of sex of an individual. Why? Because here both are same, so they can transfer to any one of them. They will be same. XX will be getting. But when you go here, it is consisting of heterozygous condition. Here X and Y chromosome is present. So due to this variation in chromosome, the human beings, particularly male, is responsible in estimation of sex in human beings. Why? Because during reproduction process, if the sperm cell, this is the sperm cell, if the sperm cell consisting of X chromosome and the egg cell consisting of X chromosome, and what will be forming is XX. So XX is, we know that, always female. Is it right? Whereas if the sperm cell carries Y chromosome and the X, and here both are same, so X again, the X cell carries X, and what is the male? XY, and XY is always male. Who decides the sex of human beings, sir? Male only. Understand? If a chromosome carries X, the sperm cell carries X and fuses with X, X cell, and the offspring is female. If the sperm cell carries Y chromosome and fertilizes with the X chromosome, and the newborn offspring is male. Understand? That is what you can see, that the male is playing a key role in the sex determination. So this is how the crossing over is occurring. Let us see the sex determination. So, what is the pair of chromosomes is 44 is autosomes and one pair is allosomes.
external. And one way what we have is in case it is male. Now we are about to passing over. And female 44 plus XX. This is the female. How the Mendel conducted experiment? F1 generation, F2 generation, like that. Now let us see. Segregation is going to occur. During segregation, these 44 is equally divided into 2 gametes. So 44 divided into 22 plus X, 1 gamete, and 22 plus Y, 1 gamete is formed. 22 divided into total 44 XY, that is what. And here also the same. The segregation is going to occur. 22 plus X, 22 plus X. So now allows crossing over. So this crosses with this one. 22 plus 22, 44 X X.
Female, XY is always male, and here also female, here is also male.
In this way, we can see that the sex of an individual is determined by the genes or chromosomes which are carried by the sperm cells produced by the male. That is, the father is playing a key role in the estimation or determination of offspring's gender. And the sex determination, it is an illegal process. Why? Because as we are the Indians, we have some ancient, what we are following, some tradition. The boy child will be the person who develops the our family. That is what we are thinking. So in that way, if the mother is carrying female, what they are doing? They are allowed to abortion. They are allowed to remove the pregnancy. So due to this reason, this sexual determination is an illegal process. Understand? The same thing is also can be done in different organisms also. If you observe, due to the already given name X and Y, in some other organisms they can be shown by using next letters of alphabets. And if you observe, in case of birds, the male is Z type and both chromosomes are same, but in female ZW. Now in case of birds, who is playing a key role in the determination of sex is female. Why? Because two different chromosomes are present. Understand? That's what we can see. And in case of insects, they carry same thing. The female is carrying same XX and there is no one chromosome XO. And this is the male again playing a key role in the estimation of sex of an individual. In this way, any organism, but genetically, they follow the same method of sex determination, and which we can determine earlier the embryonic development stage, and which is very important.